Hi, this is Marie with Brea Reese. Today, I'm going to show you how to paint this fun pineapple with our watercolor inks. I'm using 140-pound watercolor paper cut to an 8x10 size and taped down with washi tape. Also, a Brea Reese size 8 round brush. I'll start by adding some paint to my palette. First, lake blue. I'll put 3 drops here, 2 drops here, and 1 drop here. Next, cadmium yellow. With the yellow, I'm gonna put some in its own well here. Two drops with the 1 drop of lake blue, and 1 drop with the 2 drops of lake blue. This is gonna create the nice greens for the stem of the pineapple. Medium magenta here. And finally, I'm going to add our liquid glitter to each of the wells of paint. I've included a pineapple template in a link below the video that you can download for free to use for this project. Center the template on your paper and trace it lightly with a pencil. Using a wet-on-wet technique, we're going to start by just filling in the entire pineapple with clear water. We'll start now with the lightest green that we made at the top of the pineapple. And that's the color that we created with 1 drop of lake blue and 2 drops of cadmium yellow. Fill in the entire crown of the pineapple with this color. If your paper is still wet enough, the color will begin to bleed down the pineapple, which is exactly what we want. Now I'm going to add in a bit of the darker green that we created with 2 drops of lake blue and 1 drop of cadmium yellow. Here I'm going to add it lightly just to the edges of the leaves and the tips. You'll notice that these colors will blend in very nicely together. Now we're going to paint the pineapple, starting with cadmium yellow at the top. I'll add the cadmium yellow to a little over half of the way down. Now I'm going to add the medium magenta. First, I'll add it in right on top of the cadmium yellow and blend the two colors together, creating a pretty orange. Be sure to rinse your brush and add some medium magenta below the orange as well. Finally, we'll add just our lake blue at the bottom. I'll go along the edge first and then add more into the middle. With just water, you can pull the magenta down into the blue to create the purple and also pull the blue up into the magenta. Now use a heat tool or wait for your pineapple to dry. Now using just clear water, our same brush, and a paper towel, we're gonna add a little more dimension to our pineapple. Where the crown meets the pineapple, use your brush filled with water but not dripping and make an angled line. I'm going to go back over it again with water one more time. After just a few seconds, take your paper towel and we're going to push down and pull straight up. And you'll see how it picks the paint up but leaves some of the color behind. Continue doing this down the rest of the pineapple. And then the opposite way as well. Now that it's dry, we're going to add a little bit of paint splatter. If you just want the splatter in the white area, just cover up the pineapple with the template you used. With just a small amount of paint at the tip of your brush, Just tap your brush against the pencil to create the splatter effect. Carefully remove your tape and you're all finished. I hope you enjoyed today's project. Don't forget to like this video and subscribe to our channel.